I'm Sister Anita Pinto, belong to Missionary Sisters of Queen of the Apostles Congregation, founded by Father Antonius Maria Borwick, a Jesuit priest from Germany, Cologne. Our charism is proclamation of the Word of God, and our mission is to proclaim and witness the compassionate love of God to all, especially the women, the marginalized, the vulnerable people in the society, to empower them to create new world order. In order to fulfill our mission, we are working in different parts of the world. In North Goa, we are working in Mandrem, Sholim, Marna, Nashnola and Moira. In Mandrem, we have got primary school. From past 40 years, we are working in the school and we are forming the young minds of the children. Apart from teaching ministry, we are involved in church activities like teaching catechism, seeing the spiritual needs of the people, visiting the houses, Catholic as well as Hindus, and also we have got good rapport with people. We enjoy people's company. Even people are happy with our stay over here. We have got good cooperation from our parish priest. He is taking care of our spiritual needs and we are working hand in hand. In this way, we go where the need is great, took care and share until it hurts. Thank you.
We are Sisters of St. Joseph of Chambéry. We have begun our apostolate here in Monji from 89, and we are doing the pastoral work, visiting the families, plus the work with the Vincent de Paul, Legion of Mary. And since there was a need for a school here, a small school like nursery, the children could not go to Seolim. That time there was a ferry, and now there is a bridge. But we are running this school from 90 onwards. Until today, we have good scope of the children. And after this, they go to any other schools like Mandre, Seolim. And we are happy to be with the people, since people are very good over here and we enjoy our stay with them. Thank you.
Charism is to live the essentials of religious life without any outside sign, and to meet the needs of time and place. Then we have a prayer groups also here, once in a month.
So I teach catechism for the confirmation students, and we take part in somodai, again just like visiting the people. We mostly see to the spiritual needs of them, because since there was no religious presence here, since we came, we have started adoration here also on Fridays, and so mostly we animate it. So the people appreciate our presence over here, because whenever we are not there, they always say, "Sister, wherever you are, we have missed your presence." So that, and for, especially for the spiritual men, needs, and also because there's no priest over here regularly, so, and then visiting the sick, we go to visit, whether it's a Hindu or we know that people are sick or anything.
So good morning, I'm Father Richard, director of this Don Bosco Boys Home. I belong to the Don Bosco congregation, and Don Bosco's congregation was started by the founder of Don Bosco, started long back, almost 150 years back, and the main charism of Don Bosco is to look after youngsters, especially boys who are in very difficult situations, boys who are orphans, boys who are runaways, and this work is carried out all over the world in 146 almost countries. And in India and in Goa, we carry this work through these institutes. We have a boarding over here, we got a school, and we got a parish. So today we have got different works under the same umbrella of Don Bosco. And this work is specially carried out because Don Bosco loved the youngsters. Okay? He loved the youngsters, and because of which he has started this work. Today in Goa, we have got shelter homes. There are two shelter homes in Mapsa. We cater to about 50 to 60 boys who are orphans and semi-orphans. We also have institutes like youth centers. There are about 5 youth centers in Goa. Then we have got schools, about 6 to 7 schools, in which there are boys as well as girls who study. Don Bosco started the work for boys, but now he cater to also girls, not to leave humanity out. Okay. Then we have recently started higher education, that is Don Bosco Engineering College in Patoda. And we have got an agricultural college in Don Bosco Sulcona. And all over the world, we have got various technical institutes to which youngsters come and study. Okay. This is the way the charism of Don Bosco is carried out. And the most important thing for Don Bosco is to be present with the boys. So once you are present with the boys change.
The Congregation of Sisters of Charity of St. Anne. Our origin is from Spain, Zaragoza. We began our congregation 1804, called as Sisters of Charity of St. Anne. And St. Anne was added in 1865. Before that, we were called Sisters of Charity. And our charism is universal charity to the poorest and the neediest, up to the point of heroism, even risking our life. That is our charism. And we accept any kind of ministries, any kind of work.
And we are working in the hospital and the schools. And generally we have all the kinds of work we accept. Social work, village work, visiting the houses and reaching out to the most rural area, wherever they call us, we go. And this is our charism.
The charism of our founder is to revive the faith of all the Catholics and to rekindle charity among all the people of God and to spread his virtues among all, so that all may come under one flock, under one shepherd. Also, we work as a universal apostolate. What I mean, universal apostolate means, like, if there is a need for senior citizens' home, like people are neglected, there will be a home for the aged. Or if there is a need for education, there will be a school. And so we work according to the needs of the time. And since we have small Christian communities, there is a great participation in the small Christian communities where people gather and they share the word of God. And this way we try to work with the people, trying to bring unity among the people.
Palotine priest, and our founder is St. Vincent Paloti. He was born on 21st April 1795. There are lots of ministries which he has started. Especially, he wanted to bring lay people into the fold of Catholic Church. And especially, he did lots towards the lay people, bringing them, conscientizing them, and at the same time, the main charism was to revive faith and to re-enkindle charity. We, as a member of the Society of Catholic Apostles, our mission is to promote lay apostles. I also have with me Assistant Parish Priest Father Ludovico Gugino. He is also a member of the Palotine Fathers Brothers Society of Catholic Apostolate.
Charism is to go to the whole world and make Jesus known and loved. We have got this inspiration from our mother foundress, Saint Magdalene of Canossa, because she felt the need to make Jesus known, because Jesus is not known, so he is not loved. Today, we as the Canossian sisters go all over the world, making him known and loved, through the gift of our mother foundress, as she had chosen Christ crucified on the cross and Mother Mary, Our Lady of Sorrows, at the foot of the cross. We work with the people, giving them knowledge of education. Especially we work with the poorest of the poor and marginalized. Like a mother foundress, we carry out the mission of care of the sick by visiting the patients in the hospitals, in their families, assisting them in their sorrows and especially in their painful moments.
A congregation started by Saint Claudine Thevenet was begun on 6th October 1818. Just last year we celebrated the 200 years of our congregation. The charism is to make Jesus and Mary known and loved through Christian education in all social milieu, giving preference to the poor and among them the young. Now this is taken in a wider sense, where we give education not only academic but pastorals. In Keri, we have a little preschool where we prepare the 2.5+ to join any school in English medium. We give them a good foundation and a love for learning. We are also involved in pastoral activities, teaching catechism, altar servers, taking part in the SCC community meetings. We also help out in the parish of Thiruchol, and this year we have extended even into the Sindhudurg Diocese, the SAP Center in Aranda, at the request of Father Gilbert. And we collaborate very well with our parish priest and the deanery. We are very happy to be in the Pernem deanery, collaborating with our brothers and sisters in this ministry, reaching out to the poor and the less privileged in all, irrespective of religion, caste or creed. And we hope that at the moment with the CAA, that this will be upheld by all and the constitution be protected.